are at my favorite rock chuck place. And as you can see, this is the new gauntlet from Umarex USA. These rock chucks are about 55 yards away. They tear these trees up. I'm gonna show you guys some damage that you wouldn't believe, the holes and damage, and they cause irrigation problems. We'll be set up for them. I got Jeremy Salter behind the camera. This is American Airgunner, baby. Don't go nowhere. We're gonna go set up here in the shade and then we're gonna wait for them. They're not running so far. Oh, Jeremy. 10 yards, dude. Yes. The gauntlet done the trick. Okay, Jeremy, spin back around. See in the dirt? See his little head sticking up? Okay. Let him get up a little bit. Okay, you got him? There you go. Boom. Rock chuck, 10 yards. Spin off of him. Tell me when you got him, brother. Okay, here we go. Yes! Dude, this is something else here. Look at that. This Axion scope, this is a 6x24 power Axion scope. This thing is a tack driver up to 60 yards. Where I'm shooting these rock chucks, this is what I call a rock chuck house. Several rock chucks live in one tree, and you can tell the trees are dying, and they just make it a barren wasteland down through here. Oh, there's a big boy over there. There's rock chucks everywhere. We are not scaring them either. So Jeremy, if you'll pan off me right there at the end of the stick, you see them? Oh, there you go. Smoked him. I'm gonna shoot rock chucks until they quit sticking their heads up. And if we run out of TV time, we'll put it on YouTube. I'm gonna load this clip. This rotary magazine is a 10-shot rotary magazine. I absolutely love it. There's four of them outside that house. You see them? Got the one standing up. I'm gonna go ahead and try for him. Dude, that's 42 yards. We're on a ranch here in Wyoming, and this rancher loves it when I shoot rock chucks. But I tell you right now, I black bear hunt, I coyote hunt, I mountain lion hunt, all because of the relationship I started with rock chucks and air guns. He's got cattle laying over here. He's got a bull walking around here that y'all heard screaming a while ago. This air gun is not even bothering him. I've pulled the trigger 7 times on this hunt and shot 7 rock chucks, and we've literally been here 20 minutes. Oh, tell me when you got him. Oh, he's laying out in the grass. Okay, so I pulled the trigger 8 times. I'm stopping at 10. There's another one. Oh, okay, get the one to the left. All I can see is about... This gun's so quiet. Jeremy, do you see them turkeys up there in the background?
Yeah.
This gun is so quiet. These turkeys are sitting here watching the carnage. Okay, one on the left. You got him? Oh. Whew. Smoked chicken, baby. There was 4 or 5 over here. There's one left over here. Let's go ahead and clean up that house. I'm just gonna slip. There's a rock chuck right here. I'm gonna slip over here and grab this one. Bad thing about it, these rock chucks will be living in this house this time tomorrow. Be a whole new set moved in. Oh yeah, that's a big one right there. 2, 4, 6, 9 rock chucks, and we ain't been here 30 minutes. We're gonna probably go ahead and move up to this next house we just cleared out. We did pretty good. We cleaned them 5 out right there. Then we killed 4 off of that one. I know there's one left, but he's smarter than that. So I tell you right now, I want to pull the trigger 10 times and kill 10 rock chucks. There's one right out here, about 30 yards from that last house we cleaned out. We've moved up to this house. I've only seen a couple of rock chucks over at this house here. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to clean it out real quick. About 30 yards. Oh. Okay. Pulled the trigger 10 times, 10 rock chucks dead. What we're gonna do is, I'm gonna go over here and get this rock chuck. I'll see you at the pile. Let's close this deal up, talk about the gauntlet a little bit, wrap it up. I had a good hunt today. Right over my shoulder, Jeremy. You just tell me when you're set up. Smoked him. Oh. They don't even know we're shooting at them. Tell me when you got him. Whew, Smoked him. That puts us at 12. I'll see you guys at the pile. Man, I tell you what an epic hunt. I love this gauntlet. Fully shrouded barrel. I showed you today how important it is to have a quiet air gun. There's 12 rock chucks in this pile right here. I've been here about 45 minutes. If I had a powder burner on top of it costing me way more money, I would have ran every rock chuck in the country off. All these rock chucks were anywhere from 15 yards all the way out to 52 yards. The gauntlet performed flawlessly. Once again, I'm Steve Criner, the dog soldier. I'll catch you on the next trip.
You've been watching American Air Gunner, the only televised show all about air guns. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe at AmericanAirGunner.com. Now engage your brain and go shoot an air gun. We'll see you next time.
And we've got Tyler. Yeah. There you go. Hey, welcome back to the...
Sorry.
That wasn't your fault.
It's this spot.
Here we go. Exactly. Hey, welcome back to the Round Table. Now, today I am joined by Joe Brancato from Air Tanks for Sale. In this world, he's known as the air gun scientist. We got Rick Ward, the urban air gunner. Rick, how you doing?
I'm good.
Good to see you, man.
Good to be here.
He's the only person in the room louder than me. Well,
I don't know, man. That could be a tough one.
And we got Tyler Patner here, of course, who's our national champion competitive shooter. So, guys, this is something that we all have to deal with these days if you're an air gunner. Once you get out past the brake barrels, it's PCPs. If you got a PCP, you got to fill it up with air. First off, we want to start off with maintenance, storing, and travel. What's the best way just to store these tanks? I know people get them. Typically, they last how long? How long does an air tank last?
Well, a carbon fiber tank like this is a 15-year lifespan. You have to get it hydro tested every 5. Okay. So obviously, you got basically 3 life cycles out of the tank at that point. It's important as far as storage goes, room temperature. You don't want to let it get too hot. That's just a safety thing because you got 4,500 PSI in one of these tanks. Yeah. Relatively dry environment. You know, humidity is not a good thing for tanks, hand pumps, anything you're putting air into.
I live in Georgia, so I mean, it's extremely humid.
Humid.
When you're filling tanks up, a lot of the places have dryers on them. Mm-hmm. I fill my own tanks up at my house with my own compressor.
Okay.
And I have multiple dryers to catch any particle of moisture that may get in there.
Sure. And Rick brings up the good point. It's your source of air that's really critical. You always want to make sure that the scuba shop, the fire department, or your own compressors have adequate filtration.
So this is something destroying your gun on the inside. You don't even know what's happening because you've stored your gun in the perfectly temperature regulated safe or whatever, but yet your air tank's sitting somewhere that's getting moisture, building up moisture.
That's why you want to make sure your air sources are always dry.
What about travel?
I would say in travel, I mean, I drive a pickup truck, so I mean, and I know a lot of guys that would take and throw that thing in the bed of the truck, but one of the things that this tank does not have on it is a set of legs or a feet that will hold it.
You actually make feet.
That's the way our whole system is sold.
But it's a cradle.
So how do you get this thing on an airplane? What if you want to go to a shooting
competition? That's another good question. So there's 2 ways to do it, okay? So you have to let the air out. That's okay. The obvious thing, because you can crank on this all you want. It won't come off until the air is out. And that's the best way to ship it. Now, if you're going to go to a show or a shooting match, I'll tell you what, save yourself a lot of effort. Ship it FedEx, UPS to where you're going anyway. Why carry it on a plane? It'll cost the same,
can
probably
you ship
less.
It full?
No.
Okay, so you still have to empty it.
Still got
to
empty it, okay. Yeah. But the thing is, at least you don't have to carry it on the plane along with your other baggage. And yeah, it gets to be a hassle. When you get this off, okay, the thing I always tell guys is don't grab it by the gauge.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a no-no because it's on there pretty good, but it's still only an 1/8-inch fitting, and you could possibly shear it.
I mean,
if anything, you'll tweak the gauge. Good question that people ask. Do I need tape? No. Okay. These are what are called a straight thread. This doesn't use tape. Instead, it uses, and somebody's got 2 O-rings on here. That's why I was pulling it off nonchalantly, but you're supposed to only have 1 on here. But the gist of it, I don't know how you got 2 on there, man. The O-ring actually sits below or at least halfway into this little inset in here.
Okay.
Okay. And so what happens is, when the air pressure comes in, the O-ring goes like that. It expands to a point where it hits this, okay? And then it's captive because the top of the flange here keeps it from popping out, okay? So you only have to snug it up hand tight. And what I tell everybody is once you get it that you can't see any space, I mean, just That's it. Yeah. You don't have to go gorilla tight.
I mean, this is something, this is your mainstay, of course, being a competitive guy. Like, your air tanks, your that's your source.
In some situations, I have had to fly with a tank before, and to Joe's point, you know, you got to take everything apart. It's a big pain. TSA is looking at you funny for sure. Yeah. And then you get there, and you have somewhere that you know can fill the tank. You know, yeah. That's the important part. You have to do your research ahead of time, but if there's any way to not travel with it if you're flying, yep, figure it out, because it's a pain. If you're driving, that's just a simple thing of armoring the tank up, you know, wrapping it in something, or making sure it's protected and throwing it in the car and going.
Well, I think the point is here, guys, this is it. If you're going to get into air gun and you're going to get into PCPs, make the investment, get a good tank, make sure it's got you're going to have enough years out of it, and be smart about it. Don't go cheap on the tank, because it's only going to cost you in the long run. And if you don't want to deal with it, get yourself a brake barrel. All right, that's it for this roundtable, guys. A lot of information there. Thank you very much. Air tanks, they're a lot bigger part of the air gun world than sometimes the air gun itself. So be smart about it. We'll be right back.
Coming up, we'll finish our discussion at the range and compare a 22 long rifle with and without a silencer.
American Air Gunner is brought to you by Big Blast Caps. Have a blast. By Air Venturi, the power of air, and by Walther, built for life.